Colonic ischemia differs from some ischemic attacks that can affect the small intestine. Acute mesenteric ischemia most often involves the superior mesenteric artery from embolus or thrombi, so venous thrombi or arterial thrombi. Chronic mesenteric ischemia, what's called intestinal angina, that is, lead to proboscoprandial abdominal pain, marked weight loss caused by repeated transient episodes of inadequate intestinal blood flow. These are the branches of superior mesenteric and inferior mesenteric that can supply the colon. The branches of superior mesenteric artery, ileocolic artery, and right colic artery, and the middle colic artery. These are the branches. The branches of inferior mesenteric, superior rectal artery, sigmoid arteries, and the left colonic artery. Here, the superior rectal artery that feed the rectum. The rectum has dual blood supply from inferior mesenteric and also from the internal iliac. So the middle rectal and inferior rectal are supplying the rectum. So the rectum is the least part to be affected in patient with ischemic colitis. This the marginal branch of dromons. These are the branches that connect causing arcade between the inferior mesenteric artery and superior mesenteric artery, and it's one of the most important protective factor that can protect the colon from ischemic attacks. The splenic flexure and rectosigmoid junction are the most vulnerable part of the colon to be affected by ischemic attacks. This is the mechanism of injury, hypoxia causing a detectable injury to the superficial mucosa within the 1 hour, affecting the mucosa more than 85% of the cases. Prolonged severe ischemia leading to affect the muscular mucosa and also may affect the transmural part. The reperfusion injury is very important and may lead to more injury than the direct ischemia itself. Reperfusion injury caused by the release of cytokines and oxygen free radicals. This is the difference between colonic ischemia and small bowel ischemia. I will not mention all. This is the incidence of ischemia, about 16 per 100,000. It is more common in old age and also may affect females more than males. The incidence increased through the last 30 years by fourfold, starting with 6 per 100,000 in 1980 to 23 per 100,000 in 2009. Due to the greater awareness of the effect of ischemic colitis and the rapidly aging population and rising incidence of blood vessel disease, it is expected that the prevalence of ischemic colitis will continue to increase, especially over the next or several years. These are the types of classification of colonic ischemia: gangrenous, stricturing, and the transient, and also according to the histopathological effect, reversible colobacy, transient colitis, chronic colitis, and the stricture, fulminating and universal colitis and gangrene. Also, some are classifying them to type 1, type 2, and type 3 according to the degree of affection. Type 1 is mucosal affection, type 2 is muscular mucosa, and type 3 is a transmural affection. You see that the annual incidence of colonic ischemia is increasing by age from 1 per 100,000 to 107 per 100,000 from the age of 40 to the age of 80. What are the risk factors? There are many risk factors that can affect the occurrence of colonic ischemia. These are hypertension, coronary artery disease, diabetes, kidney disease, especially patients needing dialysis, respiratory disease, and cirrhosis. Also, hypertension was the most common co-occurring factor as a risk factor for colonic ischemia. Also, the presence of arrhythmia in the heart, mainly persistent and paroxysmal atrial fibrillation. Also, patients with myocardial infarction that can be complicated by cardiogenic shock. And the use of vasoconstrictor agent in this patient may lead to aggravation of the ischemic attacks. Philippus scleritic colitis, one of the rarest cause of ischemic colitis. It was recognized in 1991. related to venous obstruction and maybe related to the presence of diabetes or hepatic disease. And also they link this disease to herbal medicine, receiving herbal medicine, characterized by calcification of the venous system of the colon. Systemic lupus erythematosus is one of the most important risk factor. The presence of these risk factors can affect also the management of patients with ischemic colitis. Also, some factors like pathogenic microorganisms, hereditary coagulative disorders, strenuous physical activity. Those are practicing marathon or long distance running. They have some sort of colitis called running colitis. Running colitis is a special type of ischemic colitis that can occur in those patients due to splenic vasoconstriction, hypovolemia, and hyponatremia. So they are advising those who are practicing this marathon to have a good hydration before, stop non-steroidal, stop alcohol, stop coffee, and well hydrated before to avoid the occurrence of ischemic attacks. These are the drugs, some drugs that can cause ischemic colitis. Also, one of the most important is surgical rebuild of the abdominal aorta, where they are sacrificing the inferior mesenteric artery, and this leads to post-operative ischemia. And so the only solution for this is to re-implant the inferior mesenteric artery during this surgical rebuild. Also, some gangrenous ischemic colitis following the wedge resection of the lung, and also may follow the some gastrointestinal operation also and pancreatitis. Some patients with after colonoscopy develop attacks of ischemic colitis. This is probably due to two causes. The first one is the dehydration or hypotension that can occur due to long period of fasting for this patient. So and also this can occur also due to compression of the blood supply due to air insufflation during colonoscopy. In addition, a relative young age person who habitually smoke can have colonic ischemia. The risk factors for colonic ischemia in young patient are smoking, hyperuricemia, and constipation. Constipation also can lead to colonic ischemia due to increased intraluminal pressure. The use of laxative in this patient can aggravate the condition and can lead to perforation. Stercoral colitis also is a rare cause of ischemic colitis that can follow fecal impaction, which can lead to also to ulceration, perforation, peritonitis, and septic peritonitis. We see that simple causes can lead to ischemic colitis. What are the clinical presentations? Clinical presentation also depend on the degree of affection of the wall of the colon. The most common is abdominal pain, tenderness, diarrhea, the most common presenting feature. The acute attack of the pain or the acute incidence of the pain can differentiate this ischemic colitis from other colonic diseases like inflammatory bowel disease. You have to have a very high index of suspicion to diagnose ischemic colitis because of the ambiguity of symptoms in this patient. Eating can aggravate the symptoms, so patient is usually refused to eat. This is one of the critical site of affections, the isolated right colon. Because of the vas recta are less developed in this right colon, so the right colon is more severe, can lead to severe abdominal pain without bleeding or bloody diarrhea, and this needs high index suspicion to diagnose early to avoid the complications that can occur due to isolated right colonic scheme. The left side of the colon is more frequently affected, followed by the distal colon, followed by the distal colon, right colon, transverse colon, and the whole colon. These are the clinical stages, the hyperactive stage, the paralytic phase, and the shock phase is the last one, which needs immediate surgery. What are the laboratory tests? Actually, the laboratory tests are not specific in this patient, but we can do this laboratory tests, including CBC, liver function, renal function, but we have some specific tests that we can do. D-lactate is a stereoisomer of the lactic acid. It is a potential biomarker for the early diagnosis of acute ischemic attack. Also, the intestinal fatty acid binding protein is also, it has a value for diagnosing intestinal mucosal damage and has been widely studied in plasma-based marker. Also, you have to search for the hypercoagulable state in this patient, doing protein C, protein S, and antithrombin 3, as the hypercoagulable state lead to ischemic attacks of the coat. These are the tests that can assess the prognosis of the patient. Leukocyte count more than 15, hemoglobin less than 12, albumin, we discussed albumin yesterday in the acute severe acidosis, one of the most important prognostic factors in patients with colonic ischemia, and also the impairment of the liver function and renal function can lead to bad prognosis in this patient. These are the tests we can do. Abdominal plain film is not so important, except in if the patient is having or suspicious of organ perforation or intestinal obstruction. Barium enema is not used now. It is replaced by CT contrast. But barium can aggravate intestinal ischemia and lead to perforation. And also, it hinders the proper visualization during colonoscopy. Ultrasound is a very important tool for simple tool for diagnosing ischemic colitis, in spite of some said that this is a non-specific change leading to thickening of the wall, edema of the wall, and also it can differentiate from mild from severe attacks, and even in the transmural affections, they can show the heaviness of the varicolic fat in patients with transmural affection. So we can use ultrasound as an alternative to colonoscopy in patients with very high risk. MRI also can be used as an alternative, also with enteric angiography, which can also be of value in patients with atherosclerotic or thromboembolism. Also, angiography is very important to patients with isolated right colonic ischemia. This is one of the most important tools for diagnosis, CT abdomen with contrast, one of the most important tool for diagnosis. This nematosis intestinalis and the portal vein gas is also possible manifestation, and this finding may be the result of transmural ischemia and subsequent bacterial inflammation, and this one of the most important signs, but also non-specific can occur in patients with IBD, in patients with pseudomembranous colitis, in patients with radiation colitis, patients with chemotherapy-induced colitis, and the patient with AIDS colitis. These are some printing in patients with colonic ischemia. Colonoscopy is the gold standard for diagnosis. It can be done within 48 hours of the incidence of ischemia. The most frequent observation in patients with colonoscopy here, edematous and fragile mucosa, segmental erythema, petechial hemorrhages, and longitudinal ulcers. One of the most characteristic is the single stripe. Single stripe means it is a longitudinal alteration occurring along the longitudinal axis of the colon. It is rather specific but rare and also carries a good prognosis than the presence of circumferential alteration. This is the biopsy of the patient, except in patient with gangrene, but you can't do biopsy on this patient. The common pathological findings include mucosal and submucosal hemorrhage, edema, erosion, granulation and tissue hyperplasia, gland atrophy, crypt atrophy, macrophage containing cells, homocystrin, and also the presence of this ghost cell, which a cell lacking the boundaries of, lacking the delineation of cytoplasmic and nucleic boundaries. These cells are denoting the presence of tissue anoxia and death. Okay. These are the stripe sign, or the single stripe. It's a single stripe. This longitudinal ulceration, and this is very important picture, denoting that colonic ischemia may present to mass lesion in the sigmoid. This mass lesion is resembling malignancy, so you have to be aware that if you diagnose malignancy in this patient will be subjected to more. Operation or more sophisticated maneuvers or operations, and this patient is ischemic colitis. So the presentation is very important. The presentation as regard acute abdominal pain, diarrhea, and the presence of this makes the diagnosis of ischemic colitis more reasonable. And so you have to wait for the histopathology to reveal the presence of ischemic colitis rather than malignancy. This after 2 weeks and this after a few months, this is complete healing of the mass. This is one of the most important complications of ischemic colitis, the stricture formation. And this occurs in about 10% of the patient and tends to be long stricture and tends to be treated by surgery rather than endoscopic dilatation. What about the treatment? Treatment depends on the stage you are seeing with your patient. Mild disease and transient ischemic attacks occurring in about 80% of the patient usually require special treatment, no special treatment, and their prognosis is good. Hospitalization is recommended to give the patient support and also risk stratification. High-risk patient is you have to consult your surgeon, must be ready from the start in management of this patient. Conservative measure including fasting and bowel rest, and also increase the perfusion of the intestine, intravenous fluids, optimizing cardiac output, and supplemental oxygen to enhance the perfusion of the core. If a protracted course of the treatment expected, administration of total parenteral nutrition, nasogastric intubation, the patient suspected of obstruction, discontinuation of ischemic colitis related drugs. Antibiotics, there's controversial as regards the use of antibiotics. They are using antibiotics for to decrease the inflammation associated with the ischemia and also to prevent the translocation of intestinal bacteria. We use the antibiotics for 3 days and assess your patient, evaluate your patient. If your patient is responding, you can continue for 1 week. Anticoagulation, especially in patients with hypercoagulable states, we can use also in patients with cardiac problem, just necessitating also the presence of anticoagulant, especially after discharge of the patient to prevent the comorbidity of cardiac disease. Steroids are related to the occurrence of colitis, but now we have many studies recently suggestive of potential protective effect of the combination of IV antibiotics and IV steroids for patients with ischemic colitis. This is one of the studies, combination of treatment with antibiotics and glucocorticoids for severe ischemic colitis. These are some potential drugs that can aid in the treatment of ischemic colitis. Either vardenafil or prostaglandin E1. Also, polydeoxyribonucleotide, one of the mixture of nucleotides that can be used for treatment. I have 2 minutes. Ribamibide. What's this drug? You know this drug? Yes, Mucosta. Mucosta, one of the anti-ulcer drugs that can be used in patients with ischemic colitis. These are the features associated with severe ischemic colitis and the feature of conservative treatment. These are the patient factor, male gender, pre-existing renal dysfunction, history of arterial fibrillation. These are clinical features. These are the laboratory features. These are the cross-sectional features, including the nematosis incidence. This is the indication of colonic surgery, acute indication, peritoneal signs, massive bleeding, universal permanent colitis, portal vein gas, nematosis incidentalis, deteriorating clinical condition, subacute indication, and chronic indication as regards the symptomatic colonic stricture and symptomatic segmental ischemic colitis. This is the figure showing the stratification of patient management, we have said before. This is the mild, this is the moderate, this is severe cases. Risk factor associated with increased post-operative mortality. Al-ayal more than 75 years old, multiple organ failure, intraoperative blood loss, pre-operative lactate more than 2.5, acute kidney injury, post-operative intraoperative catecholamine and vasoconstrictor agents, low output failure, and subtotal or total colitis. These are the take-home messages. Clinicians usually have a low level of awareness and vigilance to ischemic colitis. because of the ambiguity of symptoms and complication forming often other associated disease. So you have to have a very high index of suspicion when you are dealing with this acutely presenting patient. For patient with typical clinical characteristic complicated with some underlying disease such as hypertension, diabetes, coronary heart disease, or whom have a special history of drug intake and abdominal surgery, the possibility of ischemic colitis should be considered. Colonoscopy combined with histopathology is the gold standard for ischemic colitis, but you have to use colonoscopy with a minimal period of preparation and minimal air insufflation. If you have CO2, it's okay. Conservative treatments mainly include bowel rest, intravenous fluids, correction of the underlying condition, and some necessary anti-infection therapy. Most patients have a positive response. Other drugs presently under evaluation include these drugs we have mentioned before, and also zoo researchers have done many useful exploration studies with respect to the development of new therapeutic drug target. There is still a lack of evidence-based data on the appropriate drug therapy of colon scheme. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Hussein.